The marriage of Caleb and Haley. Welcome you today on this special day. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I do.
Caleb and Haley, we're excited for you. We celebrate what God is doing in your lives. We celebrate Him joining your lives together. And I just ask you today, is it your desire today before God and these witnesses to publicly declare your love and commitment to one another? And do you desire today to be joined together as one through the covenant relationship of marriage?
We do.
Well, we celebrate your love for one another, and we're here to express our love to you. And we know that today love is possible because He first demonstrated His love for us by giving His life on the cross for us. So let us go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, we thank You for this beautiful day that You have blessed us with to celebrate this union that You have brought together, Lord. We pray that Your hand of blessing would be upon this time, and we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, Caleb and Haley, as we come together to celebrate your marriage, we know three things about marriage. We know that God is the maker of marriage. He designed it all the way at the beginning. He created a woman to be united with a man, to be joined together in the covenant relationship of marriage. And so today, it is God. It's not me who is marrying you. It is God who is bringing your lives together as one. He is the model for marriage. So I encourage you today to look to Christ. You love like Christ. That is an unconditional love. You love one another even when you feel like your spouse doesn't deserve your love. You love just like Christ loved us. The Bible says that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. And so as you look to Christ to be the model of your marriage, you love like Him and you forgive like Christ as well. Certainly, today is a happy day. Today is a wonderful day, but you will have days that you will struggle. And it's in those days that you must look to Christ for your strength. And also, we know that the motivation for marriage ultimately is for God's glory. Everything that we do as believers in Jesus Christ is to bring glory and honor to Jesus Christ. And so it's our prayer for you today that God will use your marriage in order to glorify Jesus Christ. Well, at this time, we have the most important part of the ceremony. This is your wedding vows. This is your covenant promise. This is the promise that you are making to one another that you're going to do your part even when your partner fails to do their part. This is the time that you're promising that you're going to love one another and stay committed to one another no matter what. So as you hold hands together, I want to start with you, Caleb. If you'll just repeat after me. I, Caleb.
Take you, Haley.
To be my wife. I promise to love and cherish you. To honor and support you. In sickness as in health. In poverty as in wealth. In the good times.
And in the bad times.
And promise to be true to you in all things.
Until death do us part.
And Haley, if you'll just repeat after me. I, Haley, take you, Caleb. To be my husband. I promise to love and cherish you. To honor and support you. In sickness as in health. In poverty as in wealth. In the good times and in the bad times. And promise to be true to you in all things. Until death do us part. Well, at this time we are going to exchange rings, so if we can go ahead and have the rings. These rings serve as a symbol of your love and faithfulness to each other. These rings serve as a sign of the promise that you have made to one another today. All right, so Caleb, we'll start with you. You'll just repeat after me. I, Caleb, give you this ring. As a symbol of my unending love and faithfulness to you alone.
Symbol as my unfailing love and faithfulness to you alone.
Haley, if you'll just repeat after me as you place the ring on Caleb's ring finger. I, Haley, give you, Caleb, this ring as a symbol of my unending love and faithfulness to you alone. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of marriage. And Lord, we pray for Caleb and Haley today. May they always seek ways to serve one another and allow their marriage to draw them towards you. Teach them your ways. Strengthen them as a couple and help them to work together as a team to accomplish your will. Lord, convict their hearts when they are wrong. Help them to learn to humbly say, I'm sorry, and to graciously learn to forgive. Fill them with passion to improve. Bless them with rich love for one another. Lord, remind them to daily say, I love you, and to mean it from their heart. Always remind them to continually look for ways to demonstrate their love for each other. We submit this marriage to you, Lord, and ask that you remain in the center of it as the foundation for everything they do. Use this marriage for your glory and praise, and we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, by the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Caleb, you may now kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Caleb Cunningham.
Restroom, use it. Could be a while. God has blessed me in my life in ways that I cannot even say. The beautiful wife, Alicia, and daughter Haley, and the daughter Whitney, and the son Zachary. And today I stand here humbled and so thankful to God that I get to celebrate the marriage of my daughter to a wonderful man. And his family, who has accepted her into their family, thank you so much for putting up with her. You know, I had a lot of words before I stood up here, and now I don't. And Chelsea sitting back here, how many times I'm going to cry. But Haley and Caleb, we've been married 23 years. And there's a lot of ups and downs in marriage. Most of them are very up. But there are times when you won't like each other, but love conquers all. And you'll be able to overcome that as long as you keep God forefront in your marriage. And you go to Him for guidance, for forgiveness, to put up with each other, to put up with Lady. That's the current one who's leaving my house next week. But marriage is a very special thing. It's hard. It's not an easy walk. It's not just today with all the fun and the activities. There's a lot of things that will face you, but there's a lot of things that you're going to overcome. And the big reason is all these people right here. The support and the love that you have of the families that support you and are with you in all of your decisions when things may not be going well and when things are going great. So from myself, from my wife, from Whitney and Zachary, Caleb, welcome to our family. We love you, son. We'll support you in everything that you do. And Haley, I knew it wouldn't get done. I love you, sweetheart. And Caleb, take good care of her because I changed her diapers. I took her to the emergency rooms when she ran 105 temperature. And she means the world to me. And I know you're the best man for her. And God bless you, buddy. Thank you. Your song together.
There could have been the summer wind playing with her hair. As the sun danced in her eyes, we were standing there. She smiled, I forgot my name, 'cause all I was thinking, maybe I'm crazy, but I'm praying that an angel will love me. You will love me. Maybe I'm a fool, but I'm still falling, asking heaven.
For being here, I want to thank everybody for the love and support they've shown Haley. Especially Haley's family from Sydney, Kansas City, Caleb. Haley, we want to welcome you to our family and thank both of y'all on the right track. There's going to be some up and down there, but you can y'all up, okay? Thank y'all. Thank you, everybody, for being
For those of y'all who don't know, I'm Haley's little sister, and I'm honored to get to be her maid of honor today. So way back when, I don't think my parents ever thought two things would happen. One, I would be Haley's maid of honor, or let alone she'd find a guy to marry. As we grew up, Haley was my typical big sister. She always abused me. She got me her ring commands like 3 times a week. Caleb, watch out for that. She'll tell you. She locked me in closets and took phones so I couldn't call her parents, and I cried. And she would always yell at me when I'd simply borrow her clothes. But she still does that last one, but at least now I don't get stabbed. As we grew up, we learned to get along and how to become friends. And I think my biggest worry was in high school when Haley was writing for the school newspaper. And one day the newspaper came out and she wrote the most depressing, saddest article on basically how love just doesn't exist. And one of my best friends is in the back. She actually was planning back then to read it at Haley's wedding one day, but we couldn't find it. And so she just had this loving article on how it just doesn't exist and it's completely pointless. And obviously we can see that that's changed. When I first learned about Haley and Caleb's first date, I just thought, oh, that's cool. I live 2 states away. I go to school in Mississippi. So y'all have fun. And then I went home one weekend and Caleb was there. I don't know if you know this, Caleb, but I was very skeptical about you at first. See, in my family, I'm the one who gives all the sass and sarcasm. But that weekend, Caleb did give it back to me, and I most definitely didn't know how to react. Because no one loved it. So time went on, Haley told me more about Caleb. They made some trips to Mississippi, and before I knew it, I got a message from him telling me it was time for him to pop the question. And I cried and once again didn't know how to reply, but I was completely filled with joy. Seeing Haley and Caleb together leaves no question for anybody that they were made by God to find each other in this world. How much I've seen their relationship grow in him, and how they sacrifice for each other, and how they grow their love each day through the love of Christ. I'm happy that I've learned to handle Caleb and he's learned to handle me. And no doubt that family get together will always be entertaining from now on. I like to think Haley chose Caleb because he's kind of like me. It's like having me around all the time. She just couldn't escape and had to. I wish you all the best for the rest of your lives, and I'm so happy that Caleb's here to keep family forever happy. As it said in the Bible, now these three remain, faith, hope, and love, but the greatest of these is love. To Haley,
hail. Hi, I'm Zach. I'm the mother of the bride, and honestly, she's going to miss her being around. I love her so much. We've done a lot together. She's raised me. And she helped my mom raise me. I'm going to miss her so much. Caleb, I just hope you take care of her. And I'm glad I welcome you to the family, brother. I finally have a brother that I've always wanted. And I just remember the time when I met Caleb. We went down to Goshen, Alabama, I think it was. And we went to the Florida Georgia Line concert. That was the most fun I had with them when they were together. And then we did another time and went down and had a pink roast. And that was one of the most fun I've ever had. And I'm glad y'all are together, and I hope y'all stay together for a long time. I love you both.
How you gonna do it if you really don't wanna dance? By standing on the wall.
Get your back up off the wall.
Tell me, how you gonna do it if you really won't take a chance? By standing on the wall.
Get your back up off the wall.
Cause I heard all the people saying,
get down on it. Get down on it.
Get down.